everybody. Welcome to another Wednesday Fun, or as we have today, Guns N' Roses. Another way to think about it is Kalashnikov, Sveshnikov, all those Ikovs. I'm hoping that's actually a gun because I have no expertise in gun. So, yeah, we have GM Boros sitting very back in the class. So if you have any questions you would like to ask him, make sure to let me know and I'll scream it out for him. Otherwise, it's just you and me. To the weather here in St. Louis today was surprisingly good, so I'm assuming people are just not thinking about chess when the weather is this good. Yeah, see, like, when no one is here, yes. When no one is here, I don't feel the need to wear masks, but if there are people here, then I would kind of, you know, do it. Also because it's club rule, city rule, state rule, and I'm assuming somewhat of a federal rule at this point. All right, so jokes aside, today we have a lot of fun stuff to talk about. I was looking and I couldn't find a good Kalashnikov game that I had, so I actually am gonna show you some theory, not just my experience. So, also thank you, Will Bear. Thank you. That's a good thing. All right, let's go ahead and just jump right in. If you're looking for any of the other Sicilian videos that we've done, please double check the playlist. We've done almost everything except this one and Rouser. So it's also been quite a while since I've played Rouser. So okie dokie, let's go. Hopefully next week will be the last Sicilian. So jumping right ahead, as Tracy is saying, it's like part 17,000. Not necessarily. I feel like it's more like the month 3 of Sicilian. I was thinking of doing a little more in-depth endgame after this. So if you have anything specific you want after we're done with Sicilian, feel free to leave a comment below. I do come back and read the comments here and there. I don't know why the mask got so much hate last week. Come on, people. All right. So first off, I want to show you a fun game that I had in Sveshnikov. So this is the main line when you're thinking about Sveshnikov. There's so many, many, many other ways that this can be played. You know, there's like a funny knight d5 here. I played that when I was like 15? Wait, no. 10 years ago, so. I'm turning 24 soon. This like knight d5 is kind of cool. If you want to give it a try for blitz, do that. But bishop g5 is the one you kind of gotta know, and b5 is logical. Again, there are a bunch of ideas you can take first. Do knight d5. There are some lines in which you can sacrifice over here. I've tried it. Not my top choice, just because I'm so stingy with materials too. Yeah, so let's just talk about knight d5. Big main stuff. So bishop e7 is very logical. There's some ideas with queen a5 too, but I don't think I've actually never had this happen to me. So if this happens, I'm assuming bishop d2, bishop d3 is the easiest way to just go for it. Bishop e7 and take. And now, there are two ginormous lines. One of them is with c3, one of them is with c4. About 10 years ago, I made the choice to, I'll try c4 for a few months, see how I feel about it, and I just stayed with it for 10 years, so. Yeah, c3 is really cool. If you feel more comfortable with c3, I feel like you should know a little about c3. Let me just give you a little overview of how I think. So I have a really, really gorgeous square. This knight is kind of stinky, so we'll hopefully be able to join the party soon. The bishop is a little weird, so the reason I like c4 is to resolve the weirdness of the bishop. And this square is the only problem that I've felt that I encounter with c4, because when I play c4, I kind of give up on this square a little bit, but when I get to play c3, then I don't, you know, have to deal with that, but at the same time I'm no longer attacking these So it's an on and off type of situation. With c4, if opponent ends up playing b4, then knight c2, you're also defending over here too, so not the end of the world, but... So what I'm trying to say is if c3, then you have good protection over here, but you don't really have any more attacks over here. If c4, you give up the square, at least pawn-wise, but you have a pretty cool attack going on here. And there are some lines when you can, you know, move your queen, bring your rook, and start doing c5 and some cool stuff like that. So again, kind of depends on how your style. In this specific, well, I was going to say in this specific game, but I have to correct myself because in the past 10 years, I've started playing c4 and I've kind of stayed with it. So first thing I want to talk about is this b4, because b4, I've encountered it a lot. Knight d4 immediately is another big one that I will also go over, but first let's talk a little b4. Knight c2, logical, and there are two big lines with castle or pawn push. So first of all, let's go ahead and talk pawn push, because to be fair, you can when you castle, I don't feel comfortable taking this over here just yet, because, well, I get a pawn fair, but black has easy compensation, and well, that also could fall. I've actually lost the game, not exactly like this, but I rushed into taking the B pawn, and I got punished really bad for it, so I learned my lesson. You do need to develop. If your king was castled, yeah, you should eat that, but otherwise, eh. So, let's talk about A5 first, because A5 feels like it's, you know, kind of defending something that doesn't need to be defended just yet. I'm gonna kind of ask the chat, what do you guys think, and gals, think we should do? Where do you think your bishop belongs? I'm assuming everybody will want to do short castle, so that's a start there. Oh, Hampton Chess, Luis, I remember you're from New York, right? Correct me if I'm wrong. Hello, Nikki. Sorry, I got too distracted by the chess, couldn't pay attention to chat. Let me also get an update. So what do you think, Grandmaster Boros? Do you feel good about this opening over here?
With which color?
Oh, that was hurtful. White?
Okay.
Okay.
No? I mean, Marozzi's structure, I can't be unhappy.
Oh, that's fair. But the pawns are kind of in your face and the queen side?
Pawns are always.
All right, well, fair, that's good. Yeah, I'm okay. Yeah. All right, so let's see. What am I seeing in the chat? Chat is, impatient? Speaking C5 already? Come on, man. Nah, C5 is too early. So you kind of have to figure out what you want to do on the bishop. So bishop D3 is one. The other side is one. There are some cool ideas like this. So there are a bunch of ideas that you can kind of want to do. Queen f3 is what I went for because I kind of knew where I want my queen to be, and I really was hoping for some funny business on the d file. And it was also right when I had started playing this, and my opponent was like 400 less strong, 400 weaker rating points. So I really wanted a less strategic way to win. I just wanted material. Yeah. And so I went for this. To be fair, taking is, you know, fine right now. I'll show you how black can avoid this, but first I'm gonna show you what happened in this game. So when black just made moves that seems fine, but it truly wasn't. So now, what do you think white can do? Black is developing, you know, black castle, black develop, black pawns are safe. What do you think we should do as white? I also got a good question. Oh, hey, Steve North. I have one acceptance. I had an interview yesterday, actually. It was so draining. I have a few other interviews lined out. I got one rejection today. That was a little hurtful, to be honest. I like that school. But It's an ongoing cycle, so I don't think I'm gonna know where I'm gonna go until like May, so. How do you feel? What do you want to do here as white?
This game is not against Mueller, right?
No. This is against Tuzi, 2013. All right, so I'm seeing some knight d3 ideas. Well, kind of keep in mind, if you do knight d3, you kind of have to deal with knight d4. So that's kind of the trade-off. As long as this knight is here, we're protecting over here. But as long as this knight is here, we can't really, you know, support our knight because the d4 square. So for that reason, it does make a lot of sense to keep this knight here. I'm seeing take the knight to get the knight to g4. I guess I'm assuming knight c3. Yeah. I'm seeing some bishop developments. Yay. And let's see. Bishop e2, so castle, knight e3. Knight f6. Yeah, knight f6 would have been the best one. And because, you know, you kind of just get a pawn right out of the opening. So I'm fine with that. But I kind of felt like I wanted to get something more out of my position, which was not the best move in the position. I went for g3. g3 is fine, but I gave bishop g5, and then I was like, why did I do this to myself? So I went bananas and I went g4. g4 is still all right. I'm not, you know, defying the laws of physics. But it makes a lot of problems because f6, how do you intend to attack? Yeah, you got a good rook, you got a good knight, you know, you can still move the queen around, move the bishop around. You have a fine position, but it doesn't really do much for you. I don't really feel like I got that great of a position going anymore. Compare this to if I actually ate the pawn. It's another weak pawn, you know, the rook is still pretty close. What am I hearing?
Car.
Oh. I've been watching too much Criminal Minds. The knight can start to get funky. You know, their bishop can come out. I like this. I think this would have been a better idea. But yeah, so I went for this. And my opponent kind of fell for the pawn idea. And they just opened up a little leeway. Instead of f6 to actually stop it, they kind of just passively responded to my threat. And now this is cool. I'm happy. And I was, well, too ambitious, and I still went for c5, which is fine, but h5 is what you should go for. You know, open up your rook. Come on, Dorsa. Open up your rook. If take. Again, you can get yourself into this position. You have a nice attack going here. You get a nice pawn eating abilities here. So a lot of fun stuff. This would have been a better choice. I went for c5, and opponents made the mistake of taking because knight d4 would have been their best because I would kind of be forced into take. Now if I take, then they opened up their bishop. They potentially opened up over here. So if they take now, I don't get the luxury of this because another banana style. I was thinking queen e7, yeah. And, you know, the king is too out there. I can't really make this attack work. So yeah, we got that going. maybe people don't just feel comfortable about a pawn to f6. But this position needed that pawn to f6 because if they didn't, then my knight gets too comfortable. Anywho, after c5, she took, I took, and this just... kind of got too comfortable for me. I'm never complaining about an easy win, but I am saying that opponents could have made it harder for me, and she just resigned here. Yeah, So this is kind of a bad way of playing it. She didn't know the ideas of bishop g5, bishop h6 earlier, which is a good idea to do them beforehand. Don't play a5, castle, bishop out first before doing this critical bishop changing diagonal idea. So let's go back and talk about what if castle. So after castle, I have few move ideas. One of them is with queen f3, one of them is with a simple funny h4. Of course there is other things like g3. I like g3 more these days, but for the longest time I was a huge fan of h4, which we'll talk about momentarily as well. But let's talk about why not queen f3 now. You know, what's the difference between having that pawn over there and this bishop over there and this bishop rather than just castling? So does queen f3 still work? And the answer is, oh god, no. Bishop, as long as they do bishop g5, it does not work. You know, I can still chase it, I can still try to get funny with it, but it doesn't work. So this is the painful game. Oof. Oof. Yeah, so, oh my god, I lost that horribly. So I took that. Logical, you know, it's a free pawn, your queen is out here, your king is right out here. Why wouldn't you eat the pawn and open your king, right? And my opponent was obviously, he was like a 2300 player and he knew what he was doing. And he started to get the queen involved. Oh, sorry for your ear. Thinking about this game hurts a little, actually. And I'm still trying to keep my pawns and I got this. I mean, they should have done that, and if I do b4, then they're just going to do this. Don't worry, though. They did it next move. Right next move. Ha! Because I'm still hopeful that I could some, you know, it's still a little attack. I can save it, and of course I couldn't. This is too dead. So, and I respectfully resigned after 20 moves. And, you know, the hurting part is that this was not a blitz game. It was a classical game. And it was a round robin, and I was trying for an IM norm, and I lost so horribly. Yeah, I'm so glad I'm not hunting norms anymore. That was painful. All right, so yes, this don't play like this. Don't chase pawns too early. Wasn't that a chapter in my book? Don't chase pawns too early. I think I did name a chapter that. Yeah, don't chase pawns too early. I spent so much move eating and dealing with. Oh, I can, you know, I can castle, I can still attack here, blah, blah. It didn't work. This is horrible. So, the lesson I learned from this is just get this bishop out. Just get the bishop out. Don't eat too fast. Go for it. So, after this game, I think it was like next year. Yeah, it was 2016, it's 2017. Yeah. I played this h4 idea and I really liked it, and my idea with h4 was simple. I'm gonna try to do this, and ideally if you exchange it, awesome, I'll just keep the king, you know, hovering on f1 or g1, and I can start getting bananas on the king side with my rook up here, and I was fine with that. So I went for h4, and my opponents, you know, they wanted to keep their pawn. Logical, people don't usually like giving up material. And I continued with my plan. Mm-hmm. The other part of the plan that I liked was that when I did h4 first, I stopped this bishop g5 ideas. So I think that it would be logical for me to do this queen f3 too and try to poke around for the bishop. I think if I was playing right now, this is something I would do rather than g3. But I went for g3 anyways, and opponent continued with g6, opening a little room. Good idea. I went bishop h3, fine, bishop back, and here I made a mistake. I should have just taken this bishop and then just gone h5. This would have been so much easier to manage, and I didn't. I just, for some god unknown reason, I went knight back. I don't ask me why. I wish I could remember. I truly don't remember. Oh, I think I was scared of what if f5, so I went back. What? Maybe part of me was hoping they would do F5 and I go here and eat it. I don't know. I mean, this is like 5 years ago. H4 was not hanging because my rook was here and I played G3 the next move. Yeah. I'm not so sure about this knight D3 idea. Alright, so opponent, I think, should have taken and then started pushing over here and like maybe knight d4 ideas, maybe keep thinking of f5 ideas. I think that's something they should have done. But they just kind of went knight e7. I'm assuming they're still pushing for f5. And again, girl, just take it and push the pawn. But in my amazing, I don't know what was going on brain, I went queen d3. Not a bad move because you're getting the queen out, you might have some rook d1 ideas, it's not the end of the world, but you definitely give your opponent too much options because now opponent can do, well, not that, I was going to say f5. And after f5, now I'm kind of going to take a minute and potentially focus, zoom in on the position while I also sip on my tea and possibly pastry. So, what do you think we should do as whites right now? Oh, I'm seeing some. Oh, Aryan, that has happened so many times. I lost so many norms because I had like a nationality problem. I had like a 24. 30 now, I like a 49, 48, and you need like 2 for a 50, and I'm like, that has happened so many times. So, alright, take your time, let me know how this goes. I'll give you a minute. What do you think whites should do? This is not an easy position, so. Wait, who's eating the free pawn?
Someone say something about eating?
Uh-oh.
Oh.
They know.
No.
Believe me, I would be happy if my knight was on d5 too. Ooh, I kind of like the h5 idea. James, I assume you're trying to mention h5, not h4. Troy boy, gotta put the drink away before class, man. I wish this was a eat rook type of deal, but the knight is still very present. Okay, let's give it 30 more seconds.
Uh-oh. What was that?
Uh-oh. Uh-oh.
Oh, hey.
How you doing? I also just realized that I have access to chat as Tracy. Do you guys want to ruin her good name?
Oh, boy.
Okay, so people kept mentioning eating, so I had to go ahead and do that. What about take? Why don't we like that? Whoops. To be fair, I was eating, But not pawns, I wish. Actually, it's kind of funny. Tracy played one of my students in the last weekend tournament. I forgot to ask her about that game, but I'll go bother her about that. Oh, that was good. Almost as good as free pawns. The problem with taking is that when black takes back, sorry, they have a bunch of fun things going along in the center. And unfortunately, when they have two bishops and mobile center is not that good for us. Because we have knights and because how we played this opening, we put a lot of eggs in the, I'm gonna keep the center closed and use the outpost basket. So it makes sense to, if f5, not to take it. If f5, it does make sense to go h5, I agree. If take, then we could just keep it, let it be. We don't want to take it because if we take it, then, you know, they can get funny with their material. So we would just kind of chill. Not let this bishop get monstery on us. Not let this other bishop get monster on us. So, question of Longcastle. I mean, big maybe. But, yeah, not sure. Thank you, Ray Lopez. The problem is, right before we started streaming, I saw a really, really amazing looking half pastry. So it was like, it was somebody else ate the other half and left the half for me, which I was very glad about because still burning Christmas games. Well, technically November, Thanksgiving games. Now that I'm thinking about it, it's more like MCAT baby weight, but yeah. So yeah, so I'm very happy with half pastries. All right, now, something about, yeah, I'm not the biggest fan of this position, if I'm completely honest. So let's just go back. Yeah, I was kind of lucky that my opponents didn't do this f5, and they just kind of changed course, which was very fine. I mean, for me, because I just got to develop, and for the life of me, why am I not eating this? Come on, Dorsa, just eat. They'll eat back. Push. It's not that hard. Come on, girl. I truly don't understand what I had so against this push. If they do f5 or whatnot, now I can do knight d5 again. I'm completely fine exchanging it because this bishop versus this knight, it's okay. It's actually pretty, you know, desirable. So I don't know why I did not do that. I want to go back 5 years in time and shake myself. All right, queen b6, I went for rook d1. Rook d1 is not a bad move, but I definitely missed out on taking. Now they took, cool, and then they went there, awesome. Finally, h5, yay. And now they just played h6, which made my life quite a lot easier. If they played f5 now, then knight d5 would have been nice. I could have started with take, and if take, then take, and if take, then knight d5. And this also does come up to a nice attack because that rook is too open. So I'm hoping that if f5, I would have taken first and then consider knight d5. But even if knight d5 first, ooh, I see. There is a mini tactic here. I missed that for a second. So black to move. What can black do? And while you guys think about that, I'll give you a little life lesson. Something that happened to me over the weekend. I got slightly scammed through a text saying something about my bank account was wrong. So I clicked on the link and bye-bye everything. Well, I didn't lose anything, but I had to call the bank and let them know, and they had to freeze everything. So over the weekend, I did not have any money. It was very sad. But everything is fine, but I had to change all the accounts, all the cards, everything. So don't click on weird links. If you get a text from your bank saying something is wrong, just call them. Don't call that number, call your usual bank. So yeah, don't get scammed. There you go. It wasn't, and like, it was very legit. It was a link similar to what I usually get. It was a number similar to what I usually get text from. So it was hurtful. It took like 6 hours total to. Anyways, a little hard. But yes, don't get scammed. Now that I managed to give you some weird chills about check your bank account and make sure nobody's stealing from you, what do you think Black should have done here if this happened? Ah, yeah. Thank you. Why are people saying Queen F2? Well, the answer is because you kind of have to. You're forced into taking it. That's your only choice. And then opponent gets to take over here and say a little hello to your king. And then your queen is also falling. So if you move the king, they can take it. Whoa. Sorry. And, I mean, theoretically, you could take this first, but not comfortable position. Not something you would sign up for. Actually, Brian Clark, not true. I have signed up for my bank to text me because that's the easiest way for me to communicate. So that is something that banks do. So I just got a text that my new card has been issued and it's on its way. So kind of reminded me to mention, don't get scammed. Yeah, so f5, knight d5 would have had that mini problem. So taking is better. Now, looking at this pawn structure, looking at the specific middle games, it is very common to have a delayed castle. So, but the delayed castle also means potential h-file stuff. So it's like a trade-off. My opponents played h6, which I think was their huge mistake that they made. And I just went for b3 because I was like, okay, so with h6, they're never going to go this. I don't think they're going to play g5, and their only hope is to do stuff here. So I'm going to block that first, then I'll deal with the king slide. And I'm actually still happy about the decision I made. g4 might be stronger, but I'm fine with b3. I think b3 is much more comfortable to just keep that aside. Block that side, move to the other way. And opponent played king h8. I mean, I think they were losing it. They just didn't know what to do. I mean, potentially you can do a4, but I could just start g4, so. After king h8, I went knight d5 again. I don't know why am I delaying my g4. I'm assuming I'm delaying g4 because I wasn't comfortable with g5 and not having f4. I'm assuming that's the only reason. So I went knight d5 and they went f5, which made my life so much easier now. It's super comfortable. They have a tiny bit of a threat, which I can easily stop. And now we got to the fun part, eating pawns part. Yeah, so I'm quite happy about this. And this was very comfortable. I just wanted to kick this rook away. I'm assuming I could have moved this knight, but I just wanted to be cautious, so I just went king e2 to bring the rook over. Yep, slide it. Oh, come on, Dorsa. Nice. Okay, I'm fine with that too. Let's kick the queen around a little, eat some pawns. I'm totally fine with that. Yep, and they're resigned. But the point that I was trying to show you about this opening was not how delicious pawns are, or pastries are, or don't get bank scammed. But to actually use these squares, there are like too many weak squares. If you, based on the pawn structure, Black has very few ideas. One of them is doing stuff in the queen side. The other one is doing stuff on the F file. So if you could diffuse both of these ideas, you're good to go. I did want to mention one other thing. If opponents played like, let's say after castle, I go, let's say I play g3, the bishop g5, I do this. The only thing I do want to mention is that there are some ideas in which if they play bishop b5, bishop b7, and so on, you might want to do bishop f5. Just kind of keep that idea in mind. It's like far ahead in the future. You're not going to do it in the next few moves. First, you have to figure out if you're going to castle or if you just want to walk with the king. But the idea of bishop f5 is there, so keep that in mind. I've had few pleasant games where I have successfully placed my bishop on f5. And their bishop was on f6, so it made things a little easier. But just kind of be comfortable with that idea. Now, let's go back. And there was one other idea. Yep, this woo, this night D4 that I wanted to mention instead of B4. I have shown this specific game that I'm about to show in a previous video, I think last year, because this is a game I had with, well, one of the two games I'm going to show was with Anna Muzychuk. It was a rapid game. I had a very comfortable position, but, well, that's not true. I had a better position, but she had a lot of compensation, so she whooped my... Yeah, it still hurts when I think about it, because theoretically at that position I could have won, and it just would have been so nice. Anywho, after this knight d4 idea, taking is fine, and this, in the game that I had with Anna, she played bishop e6, and it was quite uncomfortable, because I decided to take it, and she just let that, you know, let it stay, and I did not expect that. So here, my question to you: what will you do? Will you take this, or will you accept the sacrifice? Also, do you think that's actually a good move, rook takes pawn, or is it just a, another move that will give you advantage, but you still have to figure out how to convert it? So, let's see. I see some movement from Denis Boros. You're sitting right behind the light, so it's a slightly torture for my eyes. Also, I think I hear Tracy somewhere. Oh, I do. I think she just gave me a thumbs up. So what do we think? Are we gonna eat the rook or not? Take a6? Yeah, I did too. I was like, look, this is my one chance to get some material. I'm going for it. And she took back, stopping my castle. To be fair, this knight is really, really annoying. I cannot comfortably castle. Theoretically, I can do long castle, but I just did not have that big of a heart. And I just was like, nope, this is not happening. This could have actually happened. This is totally doable, but it's so weird. What am I gonna do now? Queen d3? Actually, maybe. But knight c2, if I could get these knights off, I would be happy. But this is too scary, and I didn't. The last thing I wanted was to sit in front of a world champion and be terrified. So I did not do that, because I thought long castle is like, I'm not mad. But it's fine. Theoretically, it's fine. I went for h4, she castled, and I went for knight c2, good move, she went rook c8, that's fine, I took, which was questionable because I could have still developed, but I took, it's okay, not a big deal, and here I went a4. My thought process was, well, my rooks are kind of crappy, so I might as well try to get them up that way, and it's not the worst way to think about it. But I think potentially king d1, potentially b3, these might be a little bit more comfortable. So let me also walk you through the other part of my thought process. I realized that I cannot lose any of these pawns, because if I do, then these are some of like little cushions for my king. If I lose those pawns, then it's kind of a very, very unfortunate situation. Michael, yes, I wish I could castle, but I don't think that's a legal move considering the queen's placement. Unless the computer will allow me. Nope. Yeah. So, I kind of went for this idea, which is fine, but scary. Thank you, Suman. And, alright, so, she went queen c4. And I kind of still continued my idea. I think my biggest mistake was like that I couldn't decide what idea to follow. I really, really wanted rook h3, but I was like, if rook h3, that's not going to be fun, right? So that can't happen. Then I really, really wanted rook a3, but then I couldn't do that again, because first of all, queen c1, I didn't really feel like giving up the rook. So, I mean, in hindsight, I guess this is comfortable because I have two passed pawns, question mark. But So with queen c4, she kind of defused both of my rook ideas. So my rooks are stuck. Now I had another chance to start just pushing this pawn and call her bluff. And I didn't. I went for f3. This still hurts to this day. F4 is fine, you know, but I think the main idea is a5. I still don't know why I didn't push this pawn. Like, yeah, I can't move the rook, so what? Opponent can't do much either. Just push the pawn and see if you can exchange stuff off. I went for f3. She continued with check, king, and then I went up. D3 earlier would have been better, but that's what she went for. And I did another good move in here. The only good move for white. What do you think we should do? F3 was okay, but it was just like F3. I mean, with the A4 pawn, I had a clear purpose. I could just keep pushing that pawn, voila. But F3, I think I self-confused a little too much. She did. She psychologically did. I felt psychologically tortured. Also, Creative King Chess, welcome to our channel. Wait, what are four types of chess? Yeah, you kind of have to go king g3, because if king f1, boom, I gotta take it, and you start losing your precious pawns. And if there is one thing that runs in my blood, is my refusal to give up pawns. Okay, so king g3, and she went the rook a8, which was fine, because, I mean, if she takes it, I'm going to be extremely happy, because if I can get the small back rank checkmate with Anna Muzichuk, I would be very happy. But she didn't. She didn't want to, she didn't want to, you know, activate my pieces. So she went for rook a8, just attacking this guy. And I went to rook d1, which is fine, but I think maybe king h3? Nah, it's fine. Let's just keep it. The other idea could have been rook e4, but I, you know, I'm a pawn eater, so I wanted to stay true to myself. And for some unknown reason, I just changed my idea. I was like, nah, I don't want to eat this pawn psychologically. Also, I do remember that I was beginning to feel the time pressure, and I just made a weird move. Taking over here, bishop e5, I would have come down. And yes, another check, I would have come down. That's fair. It's very uncomfortable, but I'm not losing. I got rid of this very annoying pawn. Surprisingly, here at f4 was the best move, which I didn't do. The other idea to consider is if I really did want to activate this rook, rook e4 would be the way to go. Because if they take, well, that will be checkmate, so they can't take. If they take this, then I will take this. If they take over here, again, wait, I can't take this because, whoops. Maybe just rook e1? Yeah, comfortable. So the I kind of momentarily gave up on this guy. That was a big mistake. And by with the move that I did and with the follow-up move that I did, yay, back rank checkmate. I completely activated all three pieces that she had, and this is now completely lost. Well, there, yeah, it's just completely lost. I can't, I like, she has three strong pieces and this super pawn, and I have nothing. It's, yeah. Oof. I still tried to fight, but I do remember I was in time trouble, but still. I played fine until here. I have advantage, and then I'm like, okay, I played good enough. It's been what, like 24 moves? Okay, time to mess it up. So don't be like 2016 Dorsa. Don't be like that. Oh my god, that's 6 years ago. Alright, yeah, it was kind of bad. I have not played her since then, no. Alright, I'm gonna show you one last game, which is in Castle. Now, in this game, I was still hungry, and I still wanted to keep my pawn, so I went for b6. That's nothing new. And, actually, hold on, who was my opponent? When was this? Oh, yeah, I won that tournament. I really enjoyed that. Yeah. Yeah, so my opponent, he was a 2100, you know, respectable rating. He went for bishop b7. And now I have a chance with this knight that I don't usually get, because usually people play b4 and push my knight here. Now I get bishop knight c4, so I took it. It would have been better to get bishop c4 and, you know, keep that idea, because now if they go rook c8, I get castle, and the bishop is no longer a problem, because usually in the Svechnikov at c4, this bishop is kind of saki-saki, because it stays back, and because of pawn structure. So I went for knight c4, and my opponent went bishop g5. I think rook c8 would be better to start activating that side, or maybe even take to get rid of that knight, but opponent went bishop g5, I developed. I'm assuming f5 would have also been nice. They went rook c8, I castle, finally f5. Now, white to move, what do you think we should do?
This is the game with Muller, right?
Finally.
Okay.
How do you feel? I'm seeing a lot of f3s. Fair. f3 would have been good. Yeah, I think f3 is fine. And if f3, I'm assuming there would have been some potential takes and some potential takes. People don't really like their rooks in Svechnikov, do they? And I mean, that's fine. I'm comfortable. It's not, you know, it's not my dream position, but I'm comfortable-ish. My king is already tucked away. So this would have been fine. F3 would have been fine. In the game, I went for B3 because I was hoping if they end up taking, maybe I can take with back with pawn. Maybe if I take with bishop, you know, I had a lot of maybes in mind, and I just wanted more protection for my knight. And if I'm not mistaken, I still had slight PTSD from the Muzichuk game. So opponent went rook C5, logical, bring pressure. And then I think I started to cross my wires and I went B4. B4 is not the best idea. Can you tell me why? Looks good, you know, it feels like, okay, I'm kicking the rook, but why do you think is not the best move? Knight c7, I don't think knight c7 would be that it either. Sacrifice exchange. Yeah, exactly. How? We're probably gonna have a guns 2.0 for next week. Just FYI. No more roses. Just guns, though. Yeah, so they could have actually just taken this. If I take, then boom. This pawn is in my face. They might be some knight t2s. This guy is falling. I actually don't really like this. I love eating material, but I don't think I would be comfortable with this. Ooh. Oh, this is going to be brutal. How can they eat this? Not yet. Then they gotta activate the queen, maybe queen f6. Oh, maybe. Ooh. Yeah. I mean, it's hard for black to find too, but nope. I don't want to look at this. This is too painful for white. So yeah, b4 is bad because black is already looking to sacrifice. So why would I push them? But of course, this is also, you know, I'm playing another human who's also not a grandmaster. Normal player, good player, 2100 FIDE, but still not a grandmaster. So I'm assuming if I was playing somebody stronger, they would have made me call out for my cat. But they played rook c8. So now what do we do? Too much eating leads to... That is true. I've definitely been there. Nah, Pishi has been in a mood recently. I had a medical school interview yesterday, well, osteopathic medicine interview yesterday, and he meowed almost nonstop for the duration of the 4 hours, and I couldn't get up to get him, so I actually had to call one of my friends to come and walk the cats because he's a spoiled boss. Beep, beep, beep. Yeah, I mean, okay, fine. Here, finally, I decided to give in and play f3 because I realized I'm too committed at this point and I do have to touch the f-pawn, because if I play something like rook c1, well, bye-bye. If I play something like knight e3, that might have worked, but then f4. So it's too uncomfortable, and f3 is the only move that actually keeps the center together, so I went for it. He took, I took, and then he went rook f6. He's trying to come up with an attack because I have extra material and, you know, I have a almost mini queen out there. So they have to do something about it. So he went rook up, and at this point I was like, you know what, I'm going to activate this guy. I'm going to keep this guy, which in hindsight it was slightly ignorant of me. Now, the best way to go about it would be if I could defuse the situation over here and then attack over there. So for example, if I could do like g3 f4, or if I could go like somehow queen e1, get the queen that way. I went for b7, and then again f4 would have been nice, but I went knight a5. I got checked. Rook h6. Wait, am I sure I won this game? I did. Yes. It's not feeling that hot anymore, is it? Especially since the opponent is threatening a two-move checkmate. I went queen e1. They got queen g5. Oh my god. h3. Holy guacamole. Alright, I'm gonna give the audience a second to kind of see what's going on here. So white to move, what do you think white should do? Yeah, it's, you know, a little hot waters. Oh boy. If you can survive the attack, your pawn on b7 is going to be a monster. So how can we survive the attack? g4, whoo! Nikki, I think you're right, yeah. Nah, g4 doesn't work. I wish it did. There are h5s, there are e4s, your pawns are too out there. So I went for rook f2, an opponent did queen g3. Queen g3 was just a blunder because I just won the piece, and believe me, I was happy about it. They should have played something like maybe rook h6, and then maybe I would have done bishop f1 to protect, and then e4. You know, they should have pushed that way. And honestly, I'm not so sure if I would have survived this. It's not easy for black to continue the attack because they're using all their power, but at the same time, it's not easy for me to defend it either. You know, maybe I can try something like this, and if they take, then I can take over here and deal with that, but still, it's very uncomfortable. I'm assuming bishop a6 is also a possibility, but I don't know if I would have, because after e4, then what am I gonna do? Okay, actually I can do f4, maybe queen. Ooh. I don't know about this. Move this rook. Oh, at least perpetual. Well, never mind. There would have been perpetual probably somewhere. Yeah, let's just go with the easiest way. Well, yeah. No, I mean, this would have been fine. My opponent definitely played well enough to deserve a draw. But yeah, I think they just lost it, and I was like, oh yeah, I'm gonna take the piece. Watch me take it. And they still tried to come up with an attack, but then my position was too solid, too comfortable, too attacky, and too yummy. Alright, so this is all I have for Svechnikov for today. I was hoping to get more into Kalashnikov, but for Kalashnikov, we are going to do that next week, because I actually want to get more in the theory of it, because it can get a little tricky. And hopefully I'm also going to be talking about this funny queen b6 next week as well. Then the week after that, Rouser, and then we can open a bottle of champagne for being done in Sicilian. Alright, we're gonna do switch to Twitch. So have your games ready. Meet me on Twitch in about 5 minutes or so. Well, actually meet Tracy because she will have an opening for us. And also, one final thing, I'm going to London tomorrow for just like 4 days. So if you are in London, hit me up. Who knows, maybe I can meet up with a few people. All right, enjoy the rest of your week otherwise, and I will see you next week.